Data acquisition. In today's session, I am going to show you how do we debug the pipeline while we are constructing the pipeline. Okay, it is often required for us to stop at some point and to analyze the details over there in that particular activity before proceeding with other activities. For instance, if you look at this pipeline, right, we are doing three activities here. One is the first activity gets some metadata details about a folder. Okay, which means in a particular folder, what are the files present and what are the files details. Okay, second activity is a for each loop activity. We are going to loop through the files which are detected by this metadata activity, right? So what we are going to do here is we are going to loop through each of the files and then we are going to do a delete operation here. Okay, so third activity is some variable activity, setting the value of a variable. Okay, so this is the high level of the pipeline. Okay, so but before we can use this for each loop, right, we need to know how this metadata activity is going to bring us the results. Based on that only we are going to construct the for each loop and further activities also. Okay, so we don't want to execute these two activities right now, but because we want to know how this activity is going to execute. Okay, so for that what I'm going to do is I'm just going to execute this particular activity alone. How can I do that? If you click on each activity, right, you are seeing some red circle above each activity. Okay, so that is what is debug or breakpoint activity in Azure Data Factory. In SSIS, right, for those who have worked there, we used to set breakpoints inside script task, inside every task, right, to stop execution there and to do some analysis. Similarly, here you have to click this red circle. Once you click this red circle, right, all the other activities look disabled. Okay, in SSIS we have the flexibility to disable activities, disable tasks. Okay, also we can execute inside data flow task also to see how records move from source to destination and all. But in Azure Factory we don't have that flexibility. It's just that you can set breakpoint till the activities which you want to analyze about. Okay, so for example, if I want to just analyze till half for each loop, I can just remove this and click on here. Okay, like that we have to do debugging in the Data Factory pipeline. Okay, I'm just going to show you how this is going to execute. This is going to ignore executing these activities but just going to execute this metadata activity. Okay, so this metadata activity, it is just pointing to my output folder. If you come to portal.azure.com and the container fs demo, inside that we have a folder output, inside that we have two files. So this metadata activity is going to look inside this output folder and bring up the details of these files. Okay, so I'll quickly run this pipeline so that we can see how this debug works. It's not going to execute for each loop or set variable activities but just get metadata activity. See here in the bottom, it has just executed the metadata activity. Okay, so how do we analyze this? We'll look at the output. So this metadata activity has brought the details in the child items tag. This is the tag which is bringing the details of the file. Okay, so what and all we are getting the details? One is name of the file and second one is type of the file, type of the object. Okay, because inside a folder we can have another subfolders also, subdirectories also. So it is important for us to identify type of each object. This dim customer.csv is a file and then again salesperson.csv is a file. So it is just bringing this metadata activities, bringing the name of the object and the type of the object in each in the directory that we are configuring. Okay, so this is all about debugging the pipeline. Okay, so if you have any questions, you let me know in the comment section, I'll try to answer. And if you haven't subscribed to my channel, please do subscribe and support me. Thanks for watching. Keep supporting.